Hey there, I'm Nat.
And I'm Lo.
And we go behind the scenes at Google learning about all the stuff we're curious about.
Earlier this summer, we spent a couple of days hanging out with the Doodles team and seeing how they actually make the doodles that you get to see on the Google homepage.
And these doodles are often much more than just drawings. They can even be games. In the past, there have been doodle games celebrating puzzles, like the Rubik's Cube, and holidays, like Chinese New Year and Halloween. So for this summer, with the whole world coming together to play games in Brazil, the Doodle team really wanted to create games that everyone with a phone could also play.
We talked to Matt, an animator and an artist, and Ben, an engineer, and found out how important both storytelling and engineering are to how a game is created.
Can you tell us how it got started and what the whole process has been like?
We were down in Brazil previously for the World Cup. One of the things that stuck in my head was seeing these fruit stalls down on the beach. So we thought, let's do an alternative fruit games with these characters.
So after you thought of this idea of the fruit stall, then what had to happen?
Everything still starts with drawings.
There's a lot of ideas here, the initial ideas, trying to work out which characters would be the most fun depending on the sport. So for instance, we have a rowing game here. I thought it was a really fun idea to have some little peas that are in a pod. From the sketches you'll see here, I think only BMX is the only one that survived as the initial pitch. It just came down to the different variations of using the phone. Would a golf game be a fun rolling game? And a swimming game would be an interesting tilt.
I was thinking from an engineering perspective, what like the mechanics would be, how would they like work well on a phone. So actually I have on here the first running game I did. It was just like old school Nintendo style, two buttons push down. Yeah, and he's like huffing and puffing. So this was like, you know, a quick prototype.
Ben also experimented with other weirder ways to play the games.
I was like, well, we could use the mic and just say banana, banana.
Banana, 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 banana.
Saying banana over and over again was frustrating, so we decided not to do it.
After thinking through all the game ideas and how they could work, the team decided to make 7 games.
BMX, water polo, swimming, tennis,
running, show jumping,
and golf.
How many times have you played this game to test it?
We did this great thing. Every day at 3 o'clock, we come together, all of us, whatever state you're in, and play each other's games.
Another challenge that the team had to work with is to make these games that anybody could play, no matter what phone they had, what language they speak, or what age they are.
Or how bad at games they are, like me.
It's fascinating to explain to a global audience without words how to control a character.
And if you want to play these games yourself, all you have to do is update the Google app, tap the doodle, and play. The games will be live until August 21st.
What game are you the best at?
Oh my God, none of them compared to the engineers. This is what I've learned. Never try and beat an engineer. Never someone that actually made the game.
You're trying to get it in the goal, but if you hit the apple, it gives you a -1. So my favorite game is actually to try to get as low a score as possible and only ever hit the apple. So feel free to make your own world. It's a world and you can play with it any way you want.
If someone could have some experience playing this game, what would you want them to have?
That they could look at inanimate objects and they actually had life, and I think that's a really fun part of animation as well, is that we're always trying to give inanimate objects bits of personality.
Watermelon!
Thanks for watching, and if you haven't already checked it out, see our other episode about the making of the Lotte Reiniger doodle, which was awesome and had all these really cool silhouette cutouts. And we might even have another one coming out later this summer about the Doodles team, so definitely check it out.
Bye!